Now unto him who is able, amen, that is able to keep you from falling and to present you, what? Faultless. That's pretty special. We talked about it a few weeks ago, that our Father is able, amen, to take the worst we were and the worst we are and make it into something beautiful. Amen. Amen. And we understand that this is a process that takes place through and by his word. Everyone knows a little bit about where we came from. Amen. Nobody knows everything except you. Amen. But I believe we all know a little bit about the roads we've traveled. Amen. And just the understanding, just the knowledge, just the assurance that God is able to take a person like me. Amen. John Newton, in his wonderful hymn of the church, Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound. Amen. He said he was able to save a what? Wretch like me. Now, I know that that doesn't translate very well in our modern day church. It doesn't translate very well in our modern day culture and in the vernacular of, amen, the everyday positive type of approach that so many ministries, amen, want to espouse today. We understand that. Amen. We no longer can talk about sin. Amen. We no longer can talk about man's need for redemption. We no longer can talk about the need for people to be saved. Forget ever being able to speak about the hell that is there if we don't serve God. Amen. No, we don't want to talk about hell. Don't mention it. Amen. 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 Everything has to what? Be coming up roses everywhere you look. I just choose to look at it this way, Pastor. I'm not going to be negative. Well, I'm here to tell you today, amen, that, amen, praise God, we're not here, amen, to be concerned about that which is positive or that which is negative. We're here to be concerned with the truth of Almighty God, amen. We're here to talk about what happens when we do it God's way and what happens if we don't. And my Bible says that he is able to keep us from falling. That means that you can fall. Anybody here? That means that you can fall. That means that if we're not doing it God's way, it's just a matter of time. It says, be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, amen, that also shall he reap. Now I know everybody wants to be told you're going to be healthy, wealthy, and wise. Everybody wants to be told that all you got to do is pray about it and God will do it. Everybody wants to be told, amen, don't worry, you're no longer a sinner, just keep on going forth. Don't worry about it, you're fine. Amen. I thank God, man. I thank God that he saved me. I thank God that I'm covered by the blood. I thank God that I'm filled of this Holy Spirit. I thank God for his grace. I thank God for his mercy. But I better be walking right. I better be walking right. Amen. You can stumble and you can fall. But I'm also glad. Oh, I thank God. I thank God that even if I fall, he's there to help me up. Amen. The psalmist in Psalm 37, if you go there with me, excuse me, in Psalm 37, we see something so wonderful when we speak about God's ability. Somebody just say God's ability. Something so powerful about God's ability. Amen. It tells us in the 21st verse of the 37th Psalm that the steps of a good man. Amen. And when we say good, we're not speaking about, amen, the fact that you do everything right, or you're just a nice person. Amen. Amen. No, that kind of goodness, amen, doesn't really impress God. Amen. But when he says the steps of a good man, we're speaking about the type of individual who is willing to do it God's way. The type of individual who is willing to dedicate their lives to God. The kind of individual who's willing to pray, amen, and to seek God and to stay in His Word, amen. The type of individual that may not be perfect, but knows that we're being perfected. Amen. He says the steps of a good man are what? Laid out. They're ordered. Somebody say ordered. They are ordered by the Lord. Amen. You think that where you are is because of the fact that you were just so smart? You think that where you are is just because you knew this person or you knew that person and you had the hookup? Amen. You think that the circumstance you're in, good or bad, is all due to you? Oh no. My Bible says God orders your steps. Amen. Amen. Sometimes He'll order our steps in such a way that there are certain things we would wish we had never had to go through. There are some things we would rather avoid. Amen. But praise God. Amen. Amen. Sometimes He'll order our steps. Amen. Where there are things that, amen, it doesn't, we like it. Sometimes we like it. Sometimes we may not. Amen. But one thing I understand, that as long as God is ordering my steps, I know that the end result is up to Him and not to me. I know it's going to be just fine. Amen. It might be hard right now in some of our lives. There may be difficulty right now. You may be going through some pain. Amen. But one thing we recognize, if you're serving God, it's only for a season. If you're serving God, it's only for a time. Amen. Amen. Your steps are being ordered. Amen. Where you are is where God needs you to be. Amen. There's no such thing as serendipity. It's a lovely word, but it doesn't exist in the spirit. There's no such thing as luck. Amen. That's foolishness, so Christians don't talk that way. We believe in the will of God. Nothing happens by chance. Nothing happens by happenstance. Amen. God ordains it all. And now, amen, amen. And I know what you're saying. But wait a minute, Pastor. I thought in the book of Ecclesiastes, I read somewhere that Solomon wrote that time and chance happen to every man. Well, if you read the book of Ecclesiastes very carefully, you recognize that Solomon was talking about under the sun. In other words, those who don't trust God, those who are doing it in their own strength, those who are trying to do what they want to do. Amen. Well, yeah, you're living your life by chance. Amen. I'm going to do it. Hopefully, I'll be all right. I'm not going to serve God, but I know I'm going to heaven. Anybody meet anybody like that? I'm not going to serve God, but I know I'm all right. I don't need your God. I don't need your heaven. I don't need that. I'm fine. Don't call me a sinner. I'm not a sinner. I'm sure you haven't met anybody like that. But they believe they're fine. They believe they're going where they're going to be with God. Everything will be fine. Amen. They're going to live a life that they want to live. They're going to live any way that they choose, but they really believe that things are going to be just fine. Amen. No, we don't believe in that kind of chance. Amen. We don't believe in that kind of chance. We believe that our lives are being ordered by God. Oh, that's so reassuring for you. That's so reassuring for me. Because that means we can't fail. Amen. Amen. And he goes on to say, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and God delighteth in his way. Amen. God is happy with the direction that you're going. He wants you to go in that direction. There's some things that have happened in my life. There's some things I've had to go through in my life that didn't make me happy. But they delighted God. Amen. They didn't make me happy. Amen. It wasn't something that I felt good about. But I'm going to tell you right now, it was necessary for my spiritual growth. It was necessary for my edification. It was necessary for my anointing. Amen. There were things that God was going to put into my life. There was spiritual responsibility God was going to bring into my life. There were things God was going to entrust to me. Amen. That I would not have been able to handle had I not gone through that difficulty. Anybody here? Amen. So don't you run away from pain. Don't you run away from difficulty. Don't you think, amen, because something is not going good right now, that you must be doing something wrong. Amen. No, stay in the Lord and do what God says, and you're going to come through this stronger. My Bible says you'll come through as pure gold. Excuse me. And he goes on to say in verse 24 that this kind of man may fall, though he what? Fall. You see that? Though he fall. See, we just read in Jude and the 24th verse, that God is able to keep us from what? Falling. So here we understand, as we look at scripture, that falling doesn't mean that you won't get knocked down. Falling doesn't mean that you won't, amen, go through some hardships. Falling doesn't mean that that you won't go through some difficulty. Amen. But it means that when you do, amen, then it tells us here, though you fall, he shall not what? Be utterly cast down. It's never over. It's never over until God says it's over. It's never done till God says it's done. I wish I had somebody who was willing to believe that today. I wish I had somebody who was willing to believe that over their marriage. I wish I had somebody that was willing to believe that over their children. I wish I had somebody that was willing to believe that over their friends. I wish I had somebody that was willing to believe that over their household. I wish I had somebody that was able to believe that over their lives, that it's not done until God says it's done. Hallelujah. Because you're going through a difficulty. Because it's not easy for you. Oh, I'm through with it. Have you ever thrown up your hands because you were frustrated with the situation? Have you ever just said, I'm not dealing with this again? Huh? Because I'm done. Nobody's ever said that. Has anybody ever been done? Glory. I'm just done. Have you ever been through? Have any people been through? I'm just through. Huh? You know what I thank God for every time I reach that part of my frustration, whenever I'm dealing with people or circumstances? I thank God. God takes me back a few years. Yes, he does.
It takes me not too long ago,
my brother. He takes me back a few years.
When a certain person,
amen,
looking like me.
Amen. Amen.
Sounding a lot like me.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
My name.
Amen.
Somebody takes me back a few years
when I was in some crazy stuff.
See, and some people, because you were able to hide some of your stuff
better than other folk. See, some folk didn't care who.
Some folk had stuff hidden.
Some folk had stuff hidden on every pillow, on every rock, around every corner. Where you are, you won't listen to me when you're strong, so I'm gonna have to get you down so you'll listen to me when you're weak. Hallelujah. So I can get something into you because you think you know it all and I need you to listen. Hallelujah. Aren't you glad that God sent you somebody and helped you and helped you? Oh my God, helped you. Yes, why? Look at what the Bible says. Look at what the Bible says. It says, he'll not be utterly cast down. For the Lord will what? Uphold him. I want you to please understand this. He will uphold that person with what? With what? Somebody say his hand. Somebody say his hand. Now hold your hand up. Now hold your hand up. Can God use that hand? Ain't nobody here. Can that God, can that hand be God's hand? Huh? Because last time I checked, no man had ever seen God. Last time I checked, amen, nobody's ever seen God at any time, but God will use people. I want to know, can God use that hand? Amen. Can you be the hand? Can you be the hand of God? Oh, I wish I had somebody. Amen. Has God ever come to you? Told you it's time to help. Told you it's time, amen, to give something back. Told you that somebody's falling. Oh, praise God. The enemy wants to destroy. You remember Peter? You remember Peter? Peter was so, he was just always so impetuous and always just speaking out the side, out the side of his head all the time. Just anything that came to his mouth, he didn't know how to keep his mouth shut. Amen. And the Bible tells us in the book of Proverbs, amen, that Peter was what we would call a fool. Why? Because the book of Proverbs says that a fool uttereth all his mind. Amen. So Peter was a fool. Amen. He didn't know how to control himself. And everything that came up, he just had to talk about it. Right? And one day Jesus just turned to him and said, Peter, listen to me, man. Do you understand that the devil has come to me about you? Think about this. Jesus is saying, listen, do you understand, Peter, that the devil came to me and said, hey, Jesus, let me talk to you a minute. That one ain't gonna make it. Just let me have him. Nobody's getting this. You know, can you hear the conversation? He's not gonna make it. Listen, you know he's not gonna make it. Right? Just let me have him. Right? Jesus says the enemy has requested that he have you so he may sift you like wheat. Wow. But what did Jesus go and say? He says, but I have prayed for you that your faith fail not. Huh? And after you have been converted, that you shall strengthen the brethren. You don't know who you might be holding up. You don't know what future pastor, what future woman of God, you don't know what future father, what future mother. You don't know whose future God may put into your hands and say, hold them up. Hold them up. Bible says I'll uphold. You see, we want to read that. Okay, God will uphold him with his hand. That's good. No. The only hand God has is yours. God can do whatever he wants, and he chose to use you. As inconceivable as that might sound. Amen. God says, I'm going to use you. I'm going to use your brokenness. I'm going to use your brokenness. Why? Because your brokenness is what has made you strong. Can you just hold on to Psalm for a minute and turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 12? 2 Corinthians chapter 12. See, this is how Paul understood it. This is how Paul understood it. Paul understood, amen, that where he was, he would never be able to be used by God. So God had to break him down to something that he could use. And Paul says in 2 Corinthians chapter 12 and the 10th verse, therefore what? He's learned now, right? He's the same one that says that I've learned in whatever state I find myself, I've learned how to be content. He didn't say I had to be happy. But he says, I learned how to be content. Amen. Happiness is situational. Amen. I like being happy because I like things going well in my life. My wife and I woke up this morning. Amen. Rolled over and kissed each other on the cheek because we got bad morning breath. Amen. And I said, I'll see you in a minute. I'm going to get a shower. Why y'all got so quiet? You don't have bad morning breath? Don't look at me crazy and don't act all fool. That's right. I gave her a kiss on the cheek. I said, I'll see you later. I got up. I said, I'm going to get me a shower. And I got in the bathroom and I turned on the water. I couldn't get any hot water. I said, oh my gosh. And let the water run some more. And let the water run some more. No hot water. So I said, let me go check out the hot water heater. So I go upstairs in the attic where the hot water heater is. And water's coming down out of the hot water heater everywhere. And I'm looking and I'm like, okay. You know, so now I'm cleaning up stuff. I'm turning stuff off. My wife hears me making all the noise. She comes up and looks, and she's pulling out stuff and grabbing sheets and whatever else. And we're trying to dry up everything before the house gets flooded with water. And I said, okay, God. All right. Really? Right now? This is what I got to deal with right now? You know? But praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. We're here. Amen. See, we're here. I don't know what you're going to have to go deal with. I don't know what you're going to go see. I don't know what situation may happen in your life. Amen. But I do know this. Amen. That wherever you are, you have to learn to be content. See, I was not happy when I saw that. I'm not happy now. Amen. Amen. I'm just not happy right now. Amen. But I'm content. It could have been worse. Could have been a whole lot worse. Praise God. Amen. I'm glad. I mean, I think about everything that could have happened. I'm glad we were there. I'm glad we weren't on vacation somewhere. I'm glad we didn't come back. Amen. And that thing had come through the ceiling. I'm glad. I mean, there's all kinds of stuff that I just thank God. Amen. Everything could have been so many different ways. But I'm just glad that things are as good as they are. Amen. Amen. I'm glad it can be fixed. Anybody here? You know what? Isn't it good to know that there may be issues of your life, but it can be fixed? Amen. This is not unfixable, so praise God. But I'm still not happy. I'm not happy, but I can be content. I can be content with the situation, even though I don't have to be happy about it. Amen. And Paul says, I have what? Learned. Amen. Contentment is a learned thing. Amen. You might not want, amen, to feel good about it, but what? When you learn to trust God, when you learn and see what God has done in the past, when you see how he's delivered you time and time and time and time again, when every time you go through something, he always comes back, amen, and does something more. Amen. When he shows you that he's never left you, he'll never leave you, he'll never forsake you, then you learn that wherever you are, that it's going to be all right. Amen. Amen. Are you all okay today? Amen. I hope you're okay. Amen. I'm the one that's not supposed to be happy. Amen. Praise God. But Paul says in verse 10, that's why I've learned to do what? Take pleasure in infirmities. Wow. In reproaches, in necessities, in persecution, in distresses for Christ's sake. For when I'm weak, then am I strong. Do you see that? When I'm weak, that's when God can get the most out of me. Amen. When I'm weak, then I'm strong. Amen. So now Paul is continuing. The psalmist continues. Amen. To tell us. Amen. In the 37th Psalm, he's saying, listen, it doesn't matter. Amen. If you fall, the Lord will uphold you with his hand. You will not utterly be cast down. He says, I have been young and now I am old, yet I have not what? Seen the righteous forsaken, nor his what? Seed begging bread. It says in verse 26, he is ever merciful and he lendeth. Do you see that? He's ever merciful and he what? Lendeth. And his seed is blessed. Glory to God. Do you see that? Why is God saying that you won't fall, church? Why is God saying that we have the ability to stay strong? He's saying because we believe in him and we're going to do it his way. But he goes on to say this in the 24th verse of Jude. He says, not only am I able to keep you from falling, he says, but I'm able to present you faultless. I'm able to have you stand before me perfect. Stand before me without any fault. Stand before me with grace. Stand before me with all the stuff you've done out of your life. So much so that no one would ever be able to know. I can have you stand before me faultless. I thank God this morning that I'm faultless. I didn't say that I hadn't committed faults. I'm not saying that I didn't do something wrong. I'm saying that today I am faultless. Why? Because of God. Amen. Because he sees me, amen, redeemed. He sees me changed. He has turned my life around. Amen. And now it says, I will present you what? Faultless before the presence of my glory. That's powerful. But not just that. He says, with exceeding joy. With exceeding joy. Doesn't really matter. With exceeding joy. I will make sure, listen, when I present you before my glory, in the presence of my glory, I'm going to be able to say, Father, look, you remember this one? Look, she's faultless. He's faultless. He allowed me to use him. He accepted me. He gave his life to me. She gave her life to me. And I used them. I used him to do great things. And now he stands before us faultless. I just want to encourage you this morning. I just want to encourage you this morning that our Father is able to do it. Amen. He's able to do it. You have to remember that. But I want to take you one step further. I want to take you one step further as I end today. Listen, remember now, if you do it God's way, you'll get God's result. But if you don't, you can't get God's result. And it says in the same 37th Psalm, it tells us in the 34th verse, amen, it tells us what happens. When that doesn't happen, when you don't serve God. And see, this is the key. Let's look at this today. Let's go back to Psalm 37 and just for a few moments, look at this. And we see it here in verse 34. It says, wait on the Lord. See, the child of God learns to what? Wait on the Lord and to what? Keep his way. And he shall what? Exalt you to inherit the land. You see that? When the wicked are cut off, you're going to what? See it. When the wicked are cut off, you shall see it. There may be circumstances going on. There may be people in your life now that are not good. Circumstances that are bothering you. Situations that are distressing you. Leave it to God. Wait on God. Wait on the Lord. And what? Keep his way. Keep his way. Because what's going to happen? It says in verse 35, He says, just like I've seen the righteous. Huh? Just like I've seen the righteous. Amen. Never seen the righteous forsaken. And just like I have never seen their seed begging bread. He says, but I've seen the wicked. He says, I've seen them. And look at what he says. I've seen the wicked in what? Great power. Did you see that? In great power and doing what? Spreading himself like a green bay tree. But what's going to happen? It says, yet he passed away, and lo, he was not. Yea, I sought him, but he could not be found. All you've got to do is leave it to God. Think about somebody in your life that was trying to destroy you. Think about somebody in your life that was trying to discredit you. Think about somebody in your life that was trying to hurt you, your family. Think about somebody in your life that you know that they were trying their best to tear your life apart. Truly think about them. What happened to them? You know what happened? God moved them out of the way. Oh, yeah. You're still standing. Amen. 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 It's nothing. Listen, it's nothing we rejoice in. Amen. We're not glad to see when somebody comes to harm or something happens to an. No, that's not what the Bible is saying. It's just that when you do it God's way, expect a God result. If you don't do it God's way, expect that result shall take place. Think about people in your life. Think about circumstances in your life. Amen. That came to destroy you. But when you kept God's way, things got better. So much so that when you look back, you can't even imagine. Amen. You look and say, how did I come through that? You came through it because God brought you through. Now unto him that is able to do what? To keep you from falling. And if you fall, it's not a permanent thing. If you fall, you won't be utterly cast down. If you fall, be encouraged. Amen. It says the righteous are going to fall. Amen. A righteous man will fall 7 times, my Bible says. But amen. But get up. Get up again. Get up and keep moving. Get up and doing God's way. Amen. Get up and keep going. Amen. God will always provide what's necessary so you're able to get up from the fall. Amen. He'll never leave you. He'll never forsake you. My word says he'll never leave you comfortless. Amen. If something comes into a child of God's life, the resources are there because God has promised. Amen. The resources, whether it be people, whether it be finances, whether it be something you need, whatever it is, God will provide because he has promised that you can never be utterly cast down. I wonder if we really understand that. And we know a number of years ago, amen, a number of years ago, coming up here in just another month now or so, on the 31st of March, amen, Sister Sharon went home to be with the Lord, my first wife. And I never forget it, and I can't stop talking about it. Because I still remember wondering how in the world, what was I going to do? How is it going to work at this point? My God was able. I looked and saw what God did now. I look all those years ago, and I look at how God changed and blessed and provided and took care of us and took care of our family. Amen. And I'm still preaching his gospel. And I still believe in God's ability. And I thank God that he's able to do exceeding abundantly above all we can ask or think. I haven't doubted God. Amen. He brought me a lovely wife. Amen. Amen. I thank God for her. Amen. I just thank God for everything he's done. Amen. But you could never see it when you were going through. See, I don't know where you are right now, but I'm telling you, please be encouraged, because God is not through with you yet. He's still got more to do. Amen. And whatever God asks you to do, do it. If God needs you to, if he wants you to hold somebody up, hold them up. If God wants to use you, amen, let him use you. Why? Because it means that your seed will be blessed. It means that he is going to make sure that you're taken care of. Amen. Don't segregate yourself and push away, amen, the things that literally need to be in your life so that God can bring blessings to you. Amen. It may not feel good, may not be something you like, but it will always be something that brings God's glory. And if it brings God glory, then it's going to encourage, strengthen, and bless you as well. Amen? Amen. Praise God. Amen. Give God the glory. Give him the praise this morning. Well, let's bow our heads. Father, we give you honor right now. We thank you for your word. And we just ask, dear God, that you continue to encourage us and strengthen us. We love you. We worship you. We thank you. We thank you for your anointing. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your joy. We thank you for your love. And we know, dear God, that you're able to do exceeding abundantly above all we can ask or think. We ask right now, dear God, in Jesus' name, that you encourage us and you help us. That with you we can do all things. Without you, dear Father, we can do nothing. We ask right now, dear Father, that you continue to uphold us by the right hand of your grace. We love you. We worship you. And we honor you, for you alone are worthy of our praise. We thank you. And we ask it all in Jesus' name. Right now, with your eyes closed, with your heads bowed, I just want to know if you truly have a relationship with Jesus Christ. If you need that relationship today is the day of salvation. Don't harden your heart. Today is the day of salvation. Don't harden your hearts. Is God speaking to somebody's life today? Is God speaking to you today? God saying to you, it's time to come. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Father, we love you, and Father, we serve you. And we know, God, that you're able to continue to do exceeding abundantly above all we can ask or think. We love you and thank you for your grace this morning. Thank you for truly showing us your ability. We love you and ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Come on and thank the Lord this morning.